to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the 2 Chainz Colly Grove sound. Now 2 Chainz and Lil Wayne teamed up to release a new album called Colly Grove, like Holly Grove, but Colly Park or College Park put together. So anyway, the project is very sub-bass heavy. So the meat of the project is all about 808s. I mean, that's, you know, dominates almost every song I've heard in 808. So today we're going to be referencing, you know, one of the dance tracks. And, you know, the production on the album is a little bit different. I can see they took hip hop and trap styles and, you know, it's made it their own thing. And that's what you need to do as well. Trap music doesn't all sound the same. It's because a lot of producers are just using the same exact approach. There are a lot of approaches you can actually use in trap music. This isn't hard trap. It's more of like a southern style trap. So let's get into it, okay? So we're going to start with a synthetic brass. Here's the secret to the sound. Now, what I would advise you to think about is how to sound design the sound for yourself, or think about retro plug-in emulations. Nexus does have a great synth brass library as well. So look for those options. A brass sound is going to be around a sawtooth sound, so those are very similar. Let's go to the factory brass folder. And let's look for an analogish style brass. So they're trying to bring back that analog feel. A couple of songs use that analog technique I showed you how to create many times here at BusyWorksBeats.com, where there's pitch variation. And we're starting to bring back that analog feel. So I've taken off the effects because I want to add the effects later. I don't want all the effects going into the mixer track. So all we really need to do right now is just come up with a nice progressive bass line. So we're going to start with quote unquote the bass line. It's not really the bass line, it's the root note for the chords. Let's right click and tap out a tempo. So we're at about 150, 148. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and let's just come up with the bottom notes for this chord progression. Now this is not the chord, it's just the root note or the bottom note of a chord. So let's start on B. Or we can go dun. So there's options. And we can go bun. Or we can go. So it depends on your chord progression. Like I said, there are different options. You can create variations. So for one, let's have that go down to the note E, and for the first one let's have it go to G, and you'll hear the different moods. You can go down further or you can go up. So again, more options for you musically. Let's continue on. Drake-ish by going down up. We're gonna go down. Okay, so the Drake sound occurs again. A lot of music theory is about shape. Chord progression is about shape. It's not about the specific note you use, it's about the shape of it. This has more of a down up shape, whereas the first progression goes straight down. Those two have completely different moods. That's what chord progressions are all about. So we can drop this down an octave just to hear it. So hit control down. So if you want a little more bass. You gotta be careful because we're gonna introduce an 808. So having too much bass will cause frequency clashing down in the sub range. So this is a nice range here. Let's listen to the other analog brass just to see if we like those timbres a little bit better. This one's a little brighter. I like the layer. Let's try analog brass 3. And this one's very sharp. So again, you get different harmonic structures there. I like the first one the most, but the second one's good. It's just going to be too bright because remember, brass and vocals are, they live in the same frequency range, and it can get really difficult balancing the two, especially if you hold out the brass. So that we're going to use analog brass 1. Let's right click. Let's go to our playlist. Let's right click the pattern icon. Just add that in. So now we have a 16 bar or 8 bar, because we're going to be producing at halftime or half the BPM. the perception of, at least. So anyway, we're going to go about 16 bars. That's going to be the core of our song. Now we need to worry about the actual sound. So for one, I'm going to take off the effects again. And two, I'm going to filter it in the plugin. So I'm going to use a high pass filter, HP. That's going to cut out the low frequencies. You can also change the curvature. But anyway, for high pass, you want to lower the cutoff until you reach a point where you're not cutting out too much of the sound. So here's about a good spot. You can also change the curvature of the filter to make it a little more subtle. So it adds a little more bass. So you can always try those options. 24 dB is a very sharp curve. 48 dB per octave being the one of the higher ones. So let's, so now that we have our, you know, our chord progression or our root note for the chords, now let's create a chord progression. Now every song on the album is not the same. I'm kind of combining different aspects of different songs. But let's create pattern two. And for this one, I'm going to create a pattern for the chords. Okay, let's move into pattern two. And here we're going to create chord stabs. I'll show you an easier way to do this if you don't want to manually do it the way I'm doing it. But also, you want to come up with different patterns. So sometimes you would do it the manual way to create your own patterns or even record it by hand. So now what we're going to do is create chords for each of these root notes. Whoops, zoom out a bit. So for pattern two, we have to decide if chord stabs sound good for this particular sound. So let's right click and clone the instance of Nexus just so we can pull up the other analog brass and see if it may sound better playing it as chord stabs, meaning I'm going to play a chord like this. Okay, it's a little bit different than holding a note. So you want different characteristics to the sound. So pattern two, go back to the playlist. And let's zoom in. Now here, I'm going to open up the piano roll. I'm going to turn down the volume as well. Open up the piano roll again. And now we're going to create chords for each of these root notes. You know, in short, I'm just going to draw out the chord. There's a lot more to learning chords, but I'm just going to draw out the chord. We can copy those chords. So it looks like we have the same root notes, but just switched around. So for over here, I'm going to replace that with this chord. I'm hitting shift to highlight and duplicate. Hitting control to highlight, I meant to say, and shift to duplicate. And these two are the same exact chords. But now instead of playing them, you know, with holding sustain, let's hit control A. Let's go to snap to grid. I'm going to go with a half beat. And let's hit control U. That will chop up the notes. Now that's going to be too fast. So let's control Z. Go back a bit. Let's go to beat. Hit control U. And like I said, not every song is going to have this rhythm. So sometimes it's better to do it manually. You have a little more rhythm. Now this specific sound sounds a little cheesy because the sustain is all the way up. You know, when you play a guitar, it has a pluck type of sound, and that's based on the decay curve. That's why I like the sound design, the brass, a little bit. You have a little more control over that. But let's hear it in concert. Since it's occurring a little bit more, we feel like it's a higher energy, okay? So we perceive it as higher, you know, activity. Let's hit control up to hear it an octave higher. That might work better because playing chords in a really low octave can sound very muddy. Okay, so now that we've done that, we have two different sections of the song. One's more of the verse, one's more of the hook type of area. Let's get into the 808. So let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up the 808 Science drums. Let's pull up an 808 that's different. So instead of just 808 Carbon or 808, one of the top ones, let's go through and figure out which one fits this kind of mood. This one's really long, so let's right click. I really like the sub in this one. Well, they're all subby, but I like that really sub content. I mean, I really love the sub frequency content in this one. Talking backwards this week. Let's right click, edit the sample. Let's go to the marker tab. Let's go to detect pitch regions. This 808's in the key of G. And we have a whole video on how to tune your instruments in any DAW. Let's go to the envelope. Let's right click on G. So now the 808's tuned to that key. We can play our keys on the keyboard and play the exact notes we want to play. You know, if you don't tune your 808, you don't know which notes you're playing. Let's add this. And we need a general vibe. So let's start picking out from the drums. Now the drums you want to use are going to be retro 808 drums. Or you can go with, you know, the X drums. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com/X. Let's pull up the kick. We're going to layer the kick with the 808. So we need a short kick that's punchy, doesn't have too much body to it, so that we can overlay it with the 808. There's an advanced technique on how to do that, and we show it when you go to busyworksbeats.com/MAC. I show you how to combine a kick and an 808 when you sign up. So let's see here, where are we at here? We need a lead melody to go. The genre that they're going after is more Southern trap. And the 808s are not as melodic as they usually would be. So the 808 in this song is going to be more of playing one note over and over and over again, rather than playing lots of different notes. Okay, and it gives you a different vibe. And one way to start is to copy the root notes that we created. So that's why we did that first. Let's hit Control C to copy, paste that into your 808. And now that since it's tuned, it will play the right note. I'm going to pull it up an octave because I know the 808s have low frequency. Now all we have to do is give the 808 a rhythm to match the actual song. So let's, you know, give the song a little more energy. So I'm going to use the metronome as a reference point as far as rhythm. And I'm going to shorten these notes. Let's use half steps for now. Now it sounds high pitched, but we're going to change the pitch later. And there were a lot of 808s hitting. Okay, so it's going to be a lot of activity. What you could do is use that pattern, 1, 2, 2, boom, boom, boom. You can just copy that for each note. So the next note was A, so let's just hit shift, duplicate those down to A. Let's do this for all the notes until we get bored of that pattern. Your ear will tell you when things get boring. So just listen to where your ear wants to change stuff up. We're going to duplicate this pattern for each of these notes. Get rid of the long note, duplicate it over. I'm hitting shift again when I have my notes highlighted, hit shift to duplicate. Now let's drop everything down an octave. So now we know the notes are proper. Let's listen to it in context. So you can see where there could be frequency clashing. The 808 and the brass seem to have similar frequencies. So figure out which one you want to have more dominant. In this case, the 808 is going to have a little more dominance. Now what we can do, if you want to, you know, make it very simple, you could just copy the rhythm you have for your 808. I'm going to hit Control C. Let's go to pattern 4. Hit Control V. All we need is one pattern. We don't need all the patterns. And we're just going to change the root note here to C5 so we can play the original pitch for the kick. And we're just going to layer that pattern underneath the 808. Turn off my monitor so you don't hear all this excess sub bass. Okay, so there's a famous sample. It goes who or something like that from Nolia. I forget the song. You can look it up. The famous Nolia kind of bounce. That might be the song, bounce. But you know, a lot of Nolia songs sample that pattern. So if you want to sample it, go ahead. I'm not going to sample for this video, but we will include a plucky style sound. So let's go to open up another synth. Let's go to 3X OSC, which is a three oscillator synth. We're going to start with the sine wave. Let's go to the envelope and give it a decay curve. So if you want to create your own little Nolia bounce rhythm, give it a little release, a little decay. And now you can create your own arpeggio. So I forget the pattern exactly, but let's create our own. So let's right click. Now remember, our root note is going to change. So if you want this to musically match, you can actually change this rhythm over all your root notes. So let's go to half step. I'm not sure why it's giving me that weird pattern. Let's go to pattern mode. I want it to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Not sure why it's going dun dun dun. So I guess I have a different rhythm in my mind. Let me tap out the tempo I have in my mind. Okay, so that's 103, but we're at 150. So the pattern I hear in my mind is a little bit slower than this song. So if you want to translate it and treat it like you're time stretching, think of everything half. Or you can go slower by stretching it out. So let's hear it in context. It sounds a little slow. But you don't want things to be out of time. So let's just keep it at its slow rate, but this pattern is usually at 103 BPM. That's why it sounds a little slow. So you could do the same exact pattern, or you could worry about the root note that we're playing. So it tends to work all the way through. We're not done the chord progression yet, or the root note progression. Let's see if it works with the chords. It tends to work so far. Now this is going to be an underlying rhythm. It works with the chords. Sound. Let me increase the buffer a bit. So now what I'm going to look for is a snare. So let's go to X drums. Let's pull up the snares. We're going to pull up snare EO because that's an 808 style snare. And 808 doesn't necessarily mean bass. An 808 drum kit is really full of different sounds, more than just an 808 sub bass. So let me turn up my monitors for a second. So here's the snare I'm talking about. Let's right click, let's open that up. That's going to be our main snare. Since it's more of a southern influence, you can bounce around with your snare. So it doesn't have to be just on the 2 and the 4. One more thing we want to add is a cowbell. So if we go to packs from the FL Studio native stuff, let's go to drums. Let's go back to legacy and drums and then vintage. And let's open up the cowbell. Sampled from an 808 kit. Okay, so the Nolia, you know, that's how it goes. So let's add that in. Remember, we're doing it, it's gonna sound slower because we're at a higher BPM. Now it sounds out of tune, so we need to tune that cowbell to actually match. I'm going to turn down the 808 just so we don't hear so much sub. Now our main objective here is just to tune the cowbell to match. So tuning instruments is incredibly important. And it's be ding, ding. So let's go to our pitch range, pitch wheel. And I'm going by ear. a little detuned, but it's closer. You can always lower the volume. Now, having everything pan mono, okay, you want things to fill up the stereo field. So start panning things early. Stuff like hi-hats, rhythmic stuff. Drums, I usually keep mono. And for this sound, I want to spice it up with a little reverb, but I want to keep the reverb mono. So I'm going to pull this stereo separation to the right to make it mono. Just think of it more of a Drake sound, more modern sound. Brass here is a little too loud. Let's pull that down. Also, let's cut out some of the lows with the high pass filter, like we did with the first brass. Now it's a little bit cleaner. Let's add our snare, pattern 7. Clap. Clap, yeah. Boom. Clap. Clap, yeah. Boom. Clap. Clap, yeah. Boom. Clap. That's how they talk. The boom. Clap, yeah. Boom. We're tight, yeah. You want it right, yeah. Is that snare? So that's the rhythm. They talk like that. Okay, it's the accent of their speech, so you accent that with the snare. To create a lead for the melody to help us along with our vocal. So I'm gonna go. So let's create something that follows that rhythm, or you know, motion of speech. Not only note wise, but pitch bend wise. So let's figure out the notes for my. Right, yeah, we gone right, yeah. So let's put that into a synth form. Now the synth doesn't have as much harmonic activity is my voice, so it's going to be very pure of a tone, meaning straight to the frequency. Let's turn that down. So B. So it could be F sharp or it could be B. They both sound good. So really, I can't determine because remember, this is a pure tone, so it's the pure frequency. When you speak, you don't speak at one specific frequency. You speak at a lot of different frequencies. That's why it sounds so much different than a voice. But it has some, we have to add the characteristics of our voice, like pitch bend. So I go, bing, bing, right, yeah. I go, why, yeah. So the pitch is bending up. Let's go to our wrench tool. Let's go to Portamento Monophonic. Give it a little bit of slide. Just like we would talk, we go, whoop. We don't say it in one specific pitch. Bing, bing, right. So I glide to the G here. So let's. So good. I really think I started B. Yeah. So if I land, I guess it is F sharp. It's just hard to hear sometimes. Right, yeah. Pretty much the same thing. Right, yeah. Now we're going down. So here's where I think we started the note B. And I think it can repeat. So that's the a small little thing we're going to add in the back. If you remember Southern music in 2008, 2000 to about 2010, it was a lot of sine wave stuff. And the melody would just be a sine wave and an 808 drum. It'd be crazy how simple the beats were. And they were hit dance songs. Let's add a little reverb just for to make it more modern. The decay doesn't have to be that low. We're gonna pull it back to the mix. We don't want it to stand out because remember the vocalist ultimately adds that melody. Now if you wanted to make this more clubby, you can add your 808 clap. This is from the packs. Okay, so if you wanted a 2 chains breakdown, have girls twerking everywhere, add this in. So right click, fill each 4 steps. Dip into like a more serious section where Lil Wayne would come in. Molotov, we talking Molotov. Polygirl, till I had a, I don't know. I'll do the lyrics later, but you just gotta get in the mind of the artist as you're creating. Now, we're really done. I'm trying to think of little things we can add on top of this, but we're done at this point. So again, the next section would be to add that vocal idea. I'm going to turn off the monitor so you don't hear all that extra tone in the microphone. I'm going to pull up the 808 because in the headphones it's a little weak.
Yeah, I got it right, yeah, we right here. You find me right here. All I got is right here. I'm talking right here. We ain't trying to fight, yeah. We going right, yeah. I ain't trying to fight, yeah. I'm on my side, yeah. You ain't find a sight, yeah. You find us right here. We ain't trying to fight, yeah. I throw it right, yeah. We can get it right, yeah. I'm talking right here.
It's Tunchi from Noya. That coca, that cola, a roller, a holer, a motor. That Doja, I know it's a problem when I come up on ya. That gun go, but boom ya, that bomber. It's Tunchi, Gucci, I feel like Carucci. I'm Brucey, you hate me, well sue me. I'm usually on 2 things, that codeine, that spruce tree. You know I smoke loose leaves, so high off that Lucy, Tunchi.
So again, the next step would be to add that 2 chains hook, style hook, 2 chains verse, or whatever your flavor is. If depends on if you're an artist or producer, but to give people an idea of where the song's headed, your idea. So thanks for watching today. If I have enough time, I'll record that 2 chains and Lil Wayne style idea. If you want to learn more about music theory, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory for more free music theory tutorials. It's busyworksbeats.com.